Hi gang, happy Sunday. I usually say Sunday fun day, but it's not been the greatest week for some of us, and so therefore it's not necessarily been a fun day all the way around. However, it's been a good day here. Lindsay and I spent a little bit of time together, had lunch together, did a little Pokemon-ing. So anything that would let me walk away from my computer or social media at this point is probably a good thing. So a couple things. I really am coming to talk about Friends Together stuff before I talk about the other crazy. So if you're watching this and you're a Friends Together volunteer, it's time. It is October is here tomorrow, tomorrow, right? So anyway, we're here. So that means we are 9 months, from Tanzania 2019, which will celebrate our 15th anniversary of working in Tanzania. So we have so much to do and we need so much help here in the States to make it happen. If you are at all interested in going with us this summer, we have a group up, it's running. We have all the information in, the timelines, the dates. We are going to have an extended stay this summer. I'm never, ever, 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 ever doing a short summer again for me, not for volunteers, for me, because last summer was just way too difficult to do in such a short period of time for me. However, this year we'll have trips so people can come and be there anywhere from 10 days to a whole month. And so we're gonna have two climbs, a Mount Meru climb at the beginning of the trip, which is an easier, albeit still difficult, but an easier climb than Kili. And we'll also have a Kilimanjaro climb, and that'll be toward the end of the trip. Some people are interested in doing both. God bless them. We won't make them work at all if they do both and raise money. But that, hey, they can go to the massage therapist every other day they're there if they want. That'd be great. So we'll have that. The timing is set up so that people can come climb volunteer safari, or they can come volunteer safari and then climb Kili, or they cannot climb either and volunteer the two blocks. So it's really set up. It took a lot of thinking to put it together with the folks at Zara to get it where people could really be there for a 2-week period and do everything on either side. So we've done it. It's in place. So now we got to make it happen. So these are our goals for this year. They're lofty. Okay, they're lofty, but I know that we can make this happen. So our first goal is 10,000 pads, 1,000 girls. So that's finding either 1,000 people to sponsor one girl would be 1,000 people to sponsor one girl, or 100 people to sponsor 10 girls. How are we going to do it? Or just one person to sponsor one girl at a time, $10. So I know that we can do this. I'm hoping, because several people, when we were there last year, wanted to sponsor a girl a month. And so I'm hoping that some of you will want to do that too. And so you can either send 10 bucks a month, or you can, you know, pledge the whole year at one time. However is easiest for that. And so I'm hoping that some of you can help us reach other people to do that. Challenge some women in your office or in your church group, your sorority, whoever that is, and see how many of these girls we can get pads. I know we can do this. I know we can. I'm positive that we can make this happen. So the second goal is that everybody knows we finished the tailoring school last year, but what we didn't finish is the inside, turning a small area into a resource center that will be named after Kiara, and it'll be a women's resource center with educational materials on learning to read, as well as empowerment stuff that they need. And then the other piece of that is the clinic that we're trying to build on site, because TAFCOM has over 400 women that they service, all with HIV, and then their families. And they don't have a doctor, and they, you know, these women for the most part, go with limited care. So our goal is to be able to staff that clinic at least once a month, pay to have it staffed. We can do that for $250. So I think we're gonna figure that out. But first, we gotta get the inside of the clinic finished out. So we need the equipment for that, the table, and you know, just not a lot of big things, but stuff. And so that's goal number two. So pads, finishing out the inside of the school and the clinic, goal number two. And goal number three, which makes this a lofty goal, is to raise the money to build the next classroom for the TAFCOM Minnesota school, the elementary school. And so we finished out two classrooms this last year that had been started and kind of just left there, never finished out by an organization a long time ago. So we were able to finish those two classrooms out for about $9,000. And so our goal this year is to build another large classroom, and so that's $10,000. The kids are getting bigger, and as they grow, they need more classroom space for those kids. And so that's our goal. And then the solar project goal is hopefully, my real hope for this is that this is our Christmas project and we have it done before this December. And that is that the Maasai school that was built, that we help, that it was built by Zara Charity, when it was first built, they had solar, and the solar batteries have died, and we need to replace those batteries. So that's $1,500, but we've already had $250 donated toward that project. So those are our major goals, along with the supplies that we collect. So there's several ways, again, that folks can help out easily, and that's the $10 a month. For the girls. It's holding a Change for Change campaign, whether that's just your family collecting your spare change, whether it's getting a civic organization or a Sunday school or a sorority or a support group or whoever to commit to collecting their spare change for a week, 2 weeks, 6 weeks, whatever that time period is. The month of November for Thanksgiving, whatever that is. And then we take that change and we use it toward the projects. And then of course, holding other kind of fundraisers for us or just finding people that wanna sponsor things. So we do need a lot of help. I'm not at all bashful about saying that because right now everybody knows my schedule is pretty swamped, but I'm super excited. And I hope that some of you that are have been out there and have been friends for a long time really will consider going this summer. It's a big deal. 15 years working in the same region with the same people and the differences we've seen, and be able to know that we're building each year. And so if you've at all been thinking about going before, I think this may be the summer that you really want to go. Not that anything's coming to an end or anything like that. Just it's going to be a big deal, and it means a lot. So that's where we are on that. We definitely Ipsy bags. If anybody out there has not been collecting Ipsy bags or knows a women's organization that you might can shoot a flyer to and ask them about collecting their Ipsy bags, we can never have too many of those because we use them here for our project in the States for the sanitary pads that we distribute to schools where I speak. And again, if you're new, those are not reusable sanitary pads. They are normal sanitary pads that, you know, we buy here and we fix in the Ipsy bags for teachers to give to students if they start their periods and they don't have any supplies because otherwise they have to pay for them and most of the girls don't have the money, so it's a bad situation. So we started doing that a number of years ago, and it grows exponentially every year. And I have to just have a shout out to Esther because usually it's Lindsay's job to stuff all these bags and get all this done. But with Lindsay's accident, she still has very limited mobility in her hand and everything else. She's still doing PT several times a week. And so Esther has really picked up that duty for me. And I so appreciate that locally. And then of course we have our other folks in different parts of the state putting them together and distributing them where they are. So that's a big deal always for us. But the other thing with the Ipsy bags is having them for Tanzania for the girls. So we have the bags that our volunteers sew, and we always need folks that will help sew. Teresa has a lot of material that she got last year and hopefully is gonna work on sewing some again. Trisha, Doug tried, and I think he even got the material, but it's not as easy as it seems. They're super small. I don't sew, so, but just cutting the material is a thing, and stuff. So if anybody is a sewer and wants to help with that, there's always a need for that as well. So there are things everybody can do. And the last thing, and the thing that probably, I need most is anybody that wants to help book us into places to speak. You know, now that I have a real full-time job that actually involves even Fridays, my life is a different way now. You know, it's not that easy. And so when we get into places to speak, obviously people volunteer and a lot of times donate. So if you have a Rotary Club, a Lions Club, a Kiwanis Club, your church group, I'm booking my college schedule for the winter, and I actually even have a few late fall openings. I even have 2 days in World AIDS Week that are open and not booked. So if you are college or an organization like that would like a speaker, and again, it doesn't have to be HIV, or domestic violence, sexual assault. A lot of people bring me in for motivational stuff or stress management. So, you know, we're versatile on that. And I can fit Tanzania into anything you bring me in, believe me. So, and I've started Skyping in. This has been really cool. A couple of colleges are Skyping me in this year instead of me traveling, which works out great for me and works out great for them too. Although I miss being in person because that's kind of my thing, but it does make it a lot more cost effective for everybody involved. And so I have enjoyed it the couple of times that I've done that so far. So I'll be at UCF the 16th of October for a presentation. I've got UF Pharmacy School in Orlando the week of World AIDS Week. So we do have a couple of college gigs coming up, but not too many. So definitely give me a call if that's something you want. And here comes the rain again. We have definitely been getting our share of rain in Lehigh lately. Can you hear it? It's actually good though, because the dry season is well on its way. So we need to get as much rain in before then as we can. So anyway, that's where we are. I am not going to talk about the other stuff on here because I want Ashley to be able to put this up. And so I'm going to end on this note, but I will be doing a live show later on, or if not today, tomorrow, on my personal page, so that we can kind of talk about what's going on in our country right now. But what I want to do is say to you, take care of yourself this week. It's not going to be an easy week. It's not. Turn off the TV when you need to. Walk away from social media. Let folks like me be the one to have to deal if that's what you need. And breathe. Just breathe. And don't let anybody make you feel less than you are. Do what you need to do to take care of you. I love you all. I appreciate you all. I thank you all for being a huge part of everything that we do. So take good care, and we'll see you during the week.